Hello students, welcome in class 11. I am going to teach you biology subject, and in today's lecture we will discuss some basic concepts in biology. You have already learned some of these concepts in class 8, 9 and 10. Here we are just taking the review of it. So let's get started. Here the meaning of biology is the bio means the living, and the logy means the study. So biology means it is the branch of science which deals with the study of living things, living organisms. This biology branch is again divided into two types. One is called as the zoology, and another one is called as the botany. Zoo means the animal, and logy means again the study. That means the zoology is the branch of biology which deals with the study of animals. And the next branch of the biology, which we call as a botany, and it deals with the study of plants. So these are the two important branches of biology, zoology and the botany. In this lecture, we are going to focus on this botany part of the biology. So we start first from the concept cell. Cell, we call it as a basic unit of life. Cell is the important part of the plant or important part of the living organism, which we call as a basic unit of life. This cell was first discovered by the scientist, and the name of that scientist is called as the Robert Hooke. Cell, which has the similar function, come together and form the tissue. All the tissues which have the same structure and function come together and form the organ. Similar organs form the system, and the systems which come together and form the body of living organism. So the cell is called as the basic unit of life because the body of every living organism is formed from this cell part. According to the number of cell in a particular organism, the organisms are basically classified into two types. Those organisms are called as unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms. So these cells are, according to their number, are classified into two types. One is called as unicellular organism, and another one is called as multicellular organism. According to number, the classification of cell is that unicellular and the multicellular organisms. Uni means one. That means there is the presence of only one cell in the body of that organism, while multi means many. The organism whose body is made up of only one cell is called as the unicellular organisms, while the organisms whose body is made up of many cells is called as the multicellular organisms. There are number of examples of these unicellular organisms. For example, the bacteria, then diatoms, yeast, then amoeba, etc. These are the some of the examples of the unicellular organism whose body is made up of only one cell. While the examples of these multicellular organisms are, it includes the fungi, plants, and animals. According to the structure of the cell, these cells are again of two types. One type is called as prokaryotic cell and another type is called as eukaryotic cell. See here, according to the structure, cells are of two types, prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell. Pro means the primitive and the karyon means the nucleus. While eu means true and again karyon means the nucleus. That means its name indicates its meaning. That is, according to the structure, these cells are of two types. One is called as the prokaryotic cell and another one is called as the eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cell means the cell which has very primitive type of nucleus. Nucleus is very less developed, and the example of these prokaryotic cells are, again, we call it as a bacteria, which has very primitive type of nucleus. Examples of these eukaryotic cells are, again, higher organisms, that means fungi, plants, animals. Also, here we can mention the examples of amoeba, paramecium. These are also eukaryotic organism, even though their body is made up of the single cell. Thus, here we have seen this cell, which we call as a basic unit of life. According to number of the cell, organisms are classified into unicellular and the multicellular organisms. According to the structure of the cell, cells can be majorly divided into two types, prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell. Now we'll focus on this plant part. We'll discuss somewhat little information about this plant part. So we'll see what is mean by the plant, how they have different types of the development in it, how they can reproduce. So plants are called as the multicellular organisms. They have eukaryotic type of cell. These plants are called as autotrophic because they can prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Every plant in its life cycle pass through the two important stages, and those stages are, one stage is called as the vegetative stage, or we also call as a vegetative phase, and another phase is called as the reproductive phase or reproductive stage. Initially, every plant carry out the vegetative stage and later on it form the reproductive stage. Then vegetative stage means when plant develops the organs like root, stem and leaves. Then these organs, root, stem and leaves, are called as the vegetative organs, and that stage of the plant is called as the vegetative stage. After completion of this vegetative stage, plant form the flower, fruits and and these organs are called as the reproductive organs, and they are developed after completion of these vegetative organs. So these are the two important stages in the life cycle of the plant. One of the important organ in the plant is called as the flower. Flower is a specialized reproductive part of the plant, because these flowers are only responsible for the production of the seeds. In majority of the plant, by the process of pollination, male and female gamete come close together, there will be fertilization, there will be formation of embryo, and for all this purpose flowers are important, because in the flower two important parts are present, and those parts are called as, one part we call it as a male reproductive part, and other part is called as the female reproductive part. So each flower has two important part. One is called as male reproductive part, and the other part of the flower we call it as a female reproductive part. So flower is called as a specialized part or specialized reproductive part of the plant, because it has two main parts. One is called as male reproductive part, and other is called as a female reproductive part. The male part of the flower is called as the androecium. This androecium is the important part of the flower, which we call as a male part. Androecium is made up of stamen. Stamen contain anther. In this anther there are present pollen grains, and after development of the pollen tube, from this pollen grains there is found the male gamete. Same part we'll see by the figure, and see here I will draw the figure of this androecium. This androecium is made up of the stamen, and this is the figure of the stamen. Androecium, which is made up of the stamen, this is the figure of stamen, and in the stamen there are present the bilobed anther. This is called as the filament, and in this anther, if we press this anther, you will find the powder form on your finger, and that powder form which is present in this anther is called as the pollen grains. So this is the figure of the stamen. Stamen has bilobed anther. In this anther there are present the pollen grain. This pollen grain later on form the pollen tube, and in that pollen tube you will find this male gametes. Then the next part of the flower is called as the female reproductive part. See here again, male part is called as androecium. Androecium is made up of stamen. Stamen consists of anther. Anther consists of pollen grain. Pollen grain has the male gamete. This male gamete, by the process of pollination, is carried toward the female gamete. So next part of the flower, which is the another important reproductive part, and that is called as the female reproductive part. Second part is female part of the flower. This female part of the flower we call it as a gynoecium. This gynoecium is made up of the carpel, or which we also call as a pistil. This carpel has the ovary. Ovary has the ovule, and inside the ovule we'll find the egg, which we call as a female gamete. See here, female part of the flower is called as a gynoecium. This gynoecium is made up of carpel, or which we also call as a pistil. Inside the carpel there are present ovary. Inside the ovary, ovule is present, and in that ovule there is found the egg, which we call as a female gamete. The same point we can observe by this figure, and here I will draw the figure of the carpel or the pistil. See here, this is the carpel or pistil part of the gynoecium, which has the basal swollen part. The swollen part is called as the ovary. Inside the ovary there is a presence of ovules. This one is called as the stalk. This is called as the stigma. See here, this is the structure of the carpel. Stigma, style, ovary, and inside the ovary there is presence of the ovule. So this is the female reproductive part of the flower. The male gamete get deposited on this female part, that is the part of stigma, and there will be pollination process occur, and later on there will be formation of the embryo that we call as a fertilization. So these are the two important part of the flower. One is called as the androecium, and another one is called as the gynoecium part. Then according to this androecium and gynoecium, the flowers are again of two types, and these are called as the unisexual flower, and some flowers are called as the bisexual flowers. Again, uni means one, and sexual means the reproductive part. That means when the one reproductive part is present in that flower, that is either the stamen or the carpel. Not both, but only one, either stamen or the carpel, or either androecium or gynoecium, when present in that flower, that is called as a unisexual flower. And the bi means two, and here we'll find that when the two reproductive parts are present there, that means again these are either, not either, both stamen as well as carpel when present together, that means when androecium and gynoecium present together, then that flower we call it as a bisexual flower. So when only one male part or the female part is present, that flower we call it as a unisexual flower. But when both the parts are present, stamen as well as carpel, and androecium as well as gynoecium, then that part of the flower we call it as a bisexual flower. See here, the important part of this flower is that these are the non-motile. The gametes are always come together by the process of pollination. So these stamen, which form the pollen grain, in which there is present the male gamete, while this carpel, which form the egg, which we call as a female gamete. And both this egg and this male gamete get united, and there will be formation of embryo, and later on it forms the new plant. This is very interesting thing that how pollination brings together both this female and male part close together. So in today's lecture we have seen the cell, its type, unicellular and multicellular according to its number, its structure. Really, cells are again divided into prokaryotic cell and the eukaryotic cell. Then we have seen the flower, which is the special reproductive part of the plant. This flower has both androecium and gynoecium. According to the presence of this part, flowers are classified into unisexual and the bisexual flower. Androecium part has the stamen. Stamen has the anther and anther has pollen grain, which has the male gamete. While gynoecium has the carpel. Carpel has the ori. Ori has the ovule, and inside the ovule there is the female gamete. And by the process of pollination, both this male female gamete come close together. That process we call as a fertilization, and later on there will be development of embryo and new plants are formed. Okay, thank you.